In this module, we are going to discuss about how to perform security assessment. So what is included in security assessment? It is basically a step to understand whether the controls that were agreed, whether those controls are implemented properly inside the organization or yes or no. So we have to do the assessment for that. So what are the steps included in the security assessment we are going to discuss in this module? So let's proceed. The very first step of performing security assessment is to identify the network layout. It is very important to understand that the architecture of the network that has been decided, the controls are deployed accordingly. So the architecture or the IP addresses assigned to the systems should be as per the architecture that is approved. One of the commands that will assist us in the security assessment in order to identify the network layout is ipconfig. Or fconfig or IP. Ipconfig command is basically used on a Windows machine. It will help us to understand what is the current IP address of the system, what is the subnet mask, what is the default gateway, and any other additional information, let's say the MAC address, whether this IP address is received from a DHCP server or this is a static server. All this information can be identified with just one single command, that is ipconfig. The next very useful command is the ping command. The ping command will help you to identify the connectivity between two devices. Remember, ping command does not carry any data. It is a ICMP traffic, Internet Control for Message Protocol. This ping command will help us to check the connectivity to the target machine, whether the host machine has proper path or proper route to reach to this particular destination. So we use this command. If we are getting the reply from the target machine, it means the path is correct. We can reach to the target machine. So there you can see the status. Ping statistics for 1.1. Sent 4 bytes, received 4 bytes. Loss is 0%. It means we have connectivity to the target machine. So this is also very important. The second one is Address Resolution Protocol Cache or ARP Cache. The IP addresses which are assigned to a machine are logical IP addresses. But when we talk about the MAC addresses are the physical addresses of a machine. When a company manufactures a hardware of a machine, okay, it provides with the MAC address. It does not provide with the IP address. The IP addresses are logical things that are assigned to a machine when we use them. In order for that device to function inside a network, we assign that with the IP address. But the MAC addresses are provided by the vendors themselves when they are manufacturing that product. Now, both this information is very important. There are many devices inside an organization, let's say a multi-layer switch or a router or a firewall that will be maintaining the details about the IP address and its equivalent MAC addresses as well. So ARP cache is an example for that. When you say ARP, that is Address Resolution Protocol, you get the IP address details and its equivalent MAC address. So for the first entry, what do you understand? The IP address 43.80 is assigned to a machine, that is a logical IP address, and the MAC address of that machine is this one. Similarly, the second one, 43.255, is the IP address assigned to a machine. But what is the MAC address for that? It's still not known. So we have to find out that. So based on this broadcast MAC address, we are going to get the actual IP address or the actual MAC address of this machine. So this entire information is very useful for understanding the network layout. The next important command that will be useful for route and trace route is route print. When you type this command, you get this information. The first part of the information, I would say. You get the interface details and the MAC address details and the additional description for those interfaces. Let's understand one of the entries. When you say interface number 2, this MAC address, it means this MAC address is connected or is reachable by this machine on this interface. The description for that interface is this. Let's take another entry and understand it. This MAC address can be reached through this interface of this local machine. What is the description of this particular interface? It is used for VMware purposes. This information will help the local machine to understand with which devices it can communicate and which paths are known to it. So there are many commands that can be used for finding out the network layout. You can use the route command for finding out route to the target machine. You can use the path ping command. You can use the traceset command as to how many hops are there in between the source and the destination. Now this command is basically used on a Windows machine. Similar command can be used like a trace route command on a Linux machine. You'll get the same output. It's just the syntax of the command is different. Both of this command will be helpful to identify how many devices there are in between the source and the destination. All these commands will be helpful for you to identify the network layout and the devices present inside those networks.